Welcome back to Games Revealed. I'm James and Austin Brink, and we are one. So today I want to talk about the Aya Neo Air. It has rumors, speculations, release potentially coming the end of this year, and it's looking pretty good, pretty hot for ultra PC portable gaming. So on the go, it's definitely a much smaller profile than the Steam Deck, and it's also just it's lighter than the Switch, and it's going to offer just a little bit more easiness of portability on the go for your PC titles. Now, before we get into it, make sure to like, subscribe, and bash that bell with your crowbar. Now, we can do it. So, to go into it a little bit more, some more of the features are it's going to pack in a 5.5-inch OLED display at 1920 by 1080 with a 404 PPI, which is pretty good density. It was a really good density for a 5.5 screen. So it's going to have an AMD Ryzen CPU in it, along with a GPU. So it's going to be an APU, like I believe a lot of these portable devices are going. And it's going to have the RX Vega iGPU system in it, as opposed to the newer Radeon 660M or Radeon 680M, whatever, which, I mean, a device like this wouldn't be able to handle a 680, I don't think. But with that, this thing just looks like it's built for portability, for, I don't know, battery life, but it does do well with the games like Stardew Valley, and being able to get up to 60 frames per second. They showcased a video with multiple games running really well. With that, we'll see. Even in the rumors and what's been said is that it will be able to run AAA games and be playable at 30 frames per second at 720p resolution and low quality settings with the FSR enabled. I would never do that personally. I guess that's just a little opinion there. I would not get this device to run AAA in that realm. That I'm sure maybe some games like Dead Space, maybe 2000s games, this would be perfect for that, where like the old school AAA 3D titles. But this definitely looks like a device that's more suited for 2D quick gaming on the go, and there's so many titles, so many indie titles that this would be good for. If that's what you only plan on playing on the go, then this is great. If not, then the Steam Deck, this is still not like, it's kind of a competitor for Steam Deck, and it's not, they're just trying to get into, it looks like, the smaller, more portable market and be a little bit more competitive with the Steam Deck. And the price is rumored to be less than 1,000, potentially around 500. But if they don't hit that price right, I just don't see this being a killer device. But we'll see. Like, they have to make a profit. So, I don't know. With this, I think it's going to be useful for some people. It's not something I would buy. My Steam Deck's doing great, even portability-wise, on the go. It fits in my backpack. It fits everywhere I need to. The deck is great. But this does look nice, I'm not going to lie. And maybe I'll get my hands on one and do a review of it in the future, but we'll see. So this is very similar to the size of the Nintendo Switch Lite, just to give a little bit more comparison and visuals for that. So the Nintendo Switch Lite is a more similar device as opposed to the Nintendo Switch for this, which brings in why it has a 5.5-inch screen and also some of the other reasons they have. Now, as a fingerprint reader, which is going to up the cost of it, I don't know why they did that. That's just a little bit of a weird one for me, is why they went with the fingerprint reader. Maybe they're cheap now, but it still adds cost to the whole device. So we'll see. Maybe they're not trying to hit that $500 price point. I think if they don't hit that, it's going to be kind of not good. We'll see. This is an interesting device, and it's fun to see the market continue to expand. Hopefully, Aya Neo and 1X Player don't overexpand. It seems like they have so many different devices out now that they're kind of making it hard to decide. Where the Steam Deck, it makes it really easy to decide, where they have three versions and they're all based on storage. So it's really easy to decide. Steam Deck, you're just getting the Steam Deck. It has everything that works. You know how it goes. With this, it's just another device that you're going to have to tweak until you get the right spot where the Steam Deck is going to get more and more tuned for each game on how it plays, and it's just going to work out of the box more like a console, where these are going to be more specialty devices. Just putting a comparison in there. I'm still curious, though. Like, if you really need a something on the go or even for your kids, this might be good if there's a good price point attached to it, because it really, to be honest, it's hard to beat the Nintendo Switch Lite, especially since I already have a bunch of Nintendo Switch games, and even the Odin. The Odin is priced at around $200. Like, you can't really beat that for emulating and some of those 2D games that are on Android. I will be interesting to see how this compares. It's going to be more powerful than the Odin, but we'll see. So that's it. That's my take on this whole thing. I think it's fascinating, but I also want to know what you think and how about this device. What do you think? What is it, good? Is it worth it? Are you going to maybe potentially buy it? I definitely think this is going to be a very niche market, and just curious what your thoughts are. So let me know in the comments below, and also in the description below, there are sources for where I got some of this information, so you can check that out yourself. And thank you guys for watching. Check out my other videos, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out. Later.